All right, what's up all you digital designers? Coach Kilburn with a tutorial using Adobe InDesign Creative Cloud. So as I'm working through this sample project, guys, I'll give you some reminders, okay? So guys, we're gonna practice creating a sample newsletter. So what's a newsletter? It's usually a one-page document that a company or organization or neighborhood or school, some kind of entity, we'll put out periodically, once a month, every other month, every 2 weeks, depends on the entity, okay? So a newsletter is just meant to give their viewers some information about their topic, okay? So we're going to pretend this one has something to do with a school, right? So we got an image up top, students graduating and throwing their graduation caps up in the air. We got a student here who's reading a book. We got a football field down here with some key dates. Now, guys, I'm going to kind of quickly go through and kind of recreate something that looks like this. If the video starts getting long, I won't do all the information, and I'm not trying to perfectly match the colors and things, right? I want you to have some creativity and do something that makes yours yours. So if you want to change the color scheme, you know, obviously you're going to be using different images that you're going to find on the internet. And you're just going to kind of practice making text boxes and shapes and inserting images and formatting text and blah, blah, blah. Okay, so here's an example. Guys, as a reminder, this red line represents a bleed. If we were really designing this newspaper, we would want this information to come all the way out here to the bleed. So when the printer cuts, right, it'll cut right here. We won't have any mistakes. The area up here with this blue line is called the slug. You put information for the printer in there. And this information comes from the export settings. So when you export, you can decide to put certain things up here in the slug. So guys, this red line is the bleed. The blue line is the slug. And then this purple line you see represents your margins. Right? All right. So guys, that's just something for you to look at. I'm actually going to create a new document. I've already gone to the internet and saved some images, and we're going to start to piece this together. Okay. So I'm going to go File, New. Come on, computer. File, New. I'm going to go to a new document. You can also do Control N if you like keyboard shortcuts. Okay. We're going to get into the New Document dialog box, and we're going to make some changes. Opened on my other monitor because I'm on multiple monitors. You resize it and then move it over here. So there's that new document dialog box. Okay. So guys, in this case, we're just going to go print. We're going to go with letter size. I want you to always name it. So we're going to go sample newsletter. Okay. We'll go sample newsletter 1. Right. I'm okay with it in pixels. If you want to switch it to inches, you can switch it to inches, guys. Completely up to you. Right? Orientation, we want portrait. Why? Because most newsletters are in portrait orientation. We only have one page, therefore we do not need facing pages. Facing pages is that setting that you check to create a spread. What's a spread? Two pages side by side. So not a single page, but two pages, and those two pages are side by side. One represents the left page and one represents the right page. Since we're just going with one page, you can uncheck that box. Okay. Guys, we want 3 columns. I'll show you in a minute why. But in this case, we want 3 columns. We can go with the default margins. Let's be safe and give it a bleed of 10 pixels. Right. So if this is locked and you put in 10, it will go all the way around, 10 all the way around, okay? I'm not too, oop, gotta get back up to 10. Sorry, guys, my laptop is really sensitive, okay? Not worried about a slug right now. We're not sending stuff to a printer. They don't need any information. And so now we can create. Okay, so guys, here's our document. There's our red line around the edge that represents the bleed. I don't have a slug. Here's the purple lines that represent the margins. We want to keep our text in the columns. right? Background images and background colors and shapes can come all the way out to the bleed, not the edge of the document, all the way to the bleed. But your text frames, we want to fit in these columns. So we have a 1, 2, 3 column document that gives us 2 gutters. Here's a gutter. Here's a gutter. What's the gutter? The gutter is the space in between your columns. So think of a bowling alley. When I bowl, I want my ball to stay in the lane, in the column. I get points. I don't want my bowl to drop into the gutter, my ball to drop into the gutter. All right, so keep your text in these columns. Don't let your text come into the gutters, okay? So now let's start to build this a little bit, guys. Guys, they have an image up at the top, which is kind of like their banner. So we have to make a content frame. We have to make a rectangular frame tool. We have to use the rectangular frame tool and make a content frame so that we can put some content in there. What is the content? It's going to be an image. Just going to click on the content frame. Right? Guys, it's okay if my image goes off the page into the bleed. Actually, that's what I want. That helps alleviate printing problems. Right, so we're just going to kind of size up this frame right here. Right now, guys, it doesn't have to be super specific as far as how tall it is, right? It just needs to be kind of rectangular. Now, guys, I've already saved an image of some kids outside throwing their graduation caps up in the air. So now that I have a content frame, the content frame needs to be selected. I'm going to go up to File and Place. If you've ever had to set the table for your parents, think of placing the plates on the table. Then you place the cups and glasses and bowls. You place the forks and knives either on the right or the left, right? We're going to place content in that frame. If you want to use the shortcut, Control D is placing, right? So we're going to place. Now we got to tell the computer what we're trying to place it with. Right, so I called my image, I used good keywords, I called it graduation throwing hats. I can easily find it. I'm going to click on that and hit open. So guys, it's now placed my image in my content frame. It's okay that the image comes outside of the document to the bleed. It's actually what we want, okay? Now guys, I'm going to go to my black arrow, my selection tool. If I click in the middle, see, here's this double circle. That means I can move the content around in the frame, right? So if it was showing like that, that's not good for me. There's no reference that there's students graduating, right? So you can move the content around in the frame to show the parts that you want to show, right? Guys, you pick the image. It's your newsletter. You do what you want. And then I'm going to click out, right? Boom. Now I kind of have a banner, right? Now look over here. Here's their banner. That's what I'm creating, right? Now I got to type some text right on top. So I'll do Bloomingdale newsletter. So I'm going to go here. Guys, now I got to get my type tool, right? Got to get my type tool. I'm going to make a text frame. So click and drag a text frame. It's okay that that text frame crossed a gutter because I went over 2 full columns. That's okay to cross the gutter. Just don't stay in the gutter. Okay. I'm actually going to type Bloomingdale. I'm going to hit enter to return down to the next line. I'm going to say newsletter. Right. So now I got to format the text. Look over here. Theirs is toward the bottom. And this font is a bold font and large, and this one's a skinny font and smaller. I'm going to format my text, right? Click on my text frame. I actually can make my text frame smaller if I want. And I can move it down here because we're going to have it at the bottom. I'm going to change my font to white. Okay, guys, over here, the property panel. In Photoshop, the layers panel was most important. In Adobe InDesign, the properties panel is most important. Okay, so I'll drag it over here so we can see it better. All right, here's my fill. It's on black. That's not good contrast. I got black text, but there's black back here in the image. So I need more contrast. So I'm going to click on that fill. And I'm going to change it to paper. In InDesign, paper represents white. And even though there's a black, pure black is registration. So I'm just going to change it to paper. Right? Now I want to bump my size up so I can see that text a little better. Right? In this case, newsletter is different. So I'm just going to highlight newsletter. I'm going to make that much larger. Right? And I'll have to move my text frame a little bit, but that's okay. I can move it around. Right? Too big. Overset text. That little box represents overset text. Just going to make it a little smaller. Right? Boom. So you can see it. Again, I can always move my text frame around. Guys, right now I'm using the arrows on the keyboard. Right? I'm going up. I can go right. I can go down. I can go left. Right, so I'm going to line that up. I want newsletter a little bigger. I'm going to go back to my type tool. Highlight newsletter. Make it a little bigger. Matter of fact, I want to change the font. Change to a different font. So let me go in here to my fonts. Let's go Bauhaus 93. Right, Bauhaus 93. Again, overset text. I either have to make the text smaller or I could increase the size of my text frame. Right? Maybe I go over three columns. Maybe I need to go down. Boom, there it is. So guys, when you see that overset text symbol like this, you have two choices. Make your text frame bigger if you can, or lower the size of the font. Okay, let's see if we can get in here and make this a little bigger. Guys, it's trial and error. You just got to keep playing around until it looks right. Okay. Pretty good. Let's go in here to Bloomingdale. Make Bloomingdale a little bigger. Right? And then maybe we come here and we change it from regular to bold so it shows up a little more. Boom. Click out. Check it out. Boom. It's not bad. Can't see Bloomingdale great. Let's check theirs. Right? Not bad. So we got an image. Got some text. Let's move on. Right? Let's start building some of these buckets down here, right? Now, guys, look, we did three columns because look, one, two, three columns. This picture is not in one column. It just covers one, two, three columns. This key date information down here, right? Important dates coming up in the future that you don't want people to miss. It covers one, two columns. That's fine, right? That's fine. So this isn't one column. It's actually two columns, right? So three columns, right? So let's do this little key date area down here, right? We're going to have some kind of square, rectangle, little thing up here. Let's go back to ours, right? And guys, this video is getting kind of long. After I do something here, I'm going to stop it. That'll be enough for this video. We'll finish the newsletter in a second video. I don't want to bore you to death. So let's go back here. Guys, I'm going to go back. This time I'm going to go to my rectangle tool. I don't want a content frame here. I'm just making a rectangle. Guys, if I want, I can go ahead and decide my stroke color and my fill. In this case, if you look, there really is no fill, right? Here's the stroke. So they have a rectangular shape with a stroke, but no fill, right? So here's how we do that. I've got a black stroke and a no fill. So I want to go over two whole columns. I'm going to click here and drag my shape. In this case, I do want to end at the column, right? Stroke's only 1 point. You can't see that. So we're going to have to bump that stroke up a little bit so you can see it. Now you can see it, right? Let's go back to what they have here. Okay, they got a little portion at the top. So all we're going to do is we're going to go back to that same shape tool. This time I'm going to switch my fill and stroke because I want a fill. See here, this has something on the inside. It's a fill. I'm just doing black instead of this color. And I can change that at any time. Right? So I want to put this little banner on this box up here. Guys, you can always change and alter it at any time, right? Boom. Okay. Check this out. That's two elements. Here's a shape. It's got a black fill and no stroke. See, it's got no stroke. Property panel will tell you everything about what you're clicking on. If I click on this one, I have a stroke, but no fill. If I want to move this over here, I don't want to move them independently. So check it out. I'm just going to click and swipe a box over both. I'm going to go up to Object. Everything in InDesign is an object. I'm going to go to Object and Group. If you like the shortcuts, Control G. So you have to select both items or all three, four, five, six, however many items you have. Go to Object and Group, right? So now watch, when I move one, they both move together. They are grouped. Select that. All right, now I can move them. All right, so that's that, guys. Now let's jump back to theirs. We'll do a couple more things and then I'll stop this video. It's getting kind of long already. Right? They have some text, key dates. So I just go back over here. Gotta get my type tool. I can't type black on black. You can't see black on black, right? Double click here, right? I know that I think all F's are white. Yep. So if you do six F's, these are called hexadecimals. Hex means six. Got six F's. Six F's represent white. Okay. Now when I type my text, I'm going to make a text frame, right? I can change that text frame at any time. Notice my property panel changes to meet the properties for my type tool. I'm going to type key dates. Again, for some reason, it defaulted back to black. That may happen for you. The text is there. I just need to highlight it. Come to the fill. Change my fill to paper. If you guys want to use colors, you can. Right? I'm just using black and white right now, but you can use colors if you want. All right, so now I have a fill. I want to make it a little bigger so we can see it. Maybe to fit the scheme, I want to use this same font up here, which was Bauhaus newsletter, right? Go to the top for B's. B, come on, B-A-U-S. Where are you? There it is, Bauhaus 93. Boom, key dates. Again, maybe I want to make it a little bigger so you can see it. All right. Boom. Click out. All right. So guys, look, we're starting to build a newsletter here. Look, we have a content frame at the top with content. Got some text. Got our key dates box down here. Guys, I'm going to stop the video now because it's about 15, 18, 20 minutes. That's long enough, right? It's enough for us to practice on now, and then I'll make a second video to finish it up. But I think you have enough now. You can kind of see how you create this, right? Just a shape with a fill and no stroke and a text tool on text frame on top. This is a rectangular shape with a stroke and no fill. This is just a text frame we put on top of that shape, right? So I think you're kind of starting to see what we have now. So let's see if we can get to this point in a day, and then we'll start finishing the newsletter. All right, guys, I hope that helps. We're going to do some practice here. All right, all right, all right.